Here are two common mistakes that you should avoid making when you ask your employer for medical leave or disability leave, whether it's under ADA or FEHA, which is California Fair Employment and Housing Act, or FMLA or CFRA. Mistake number one, refusing to provide your employer with additional information to support your initial request for leave if that's what they're asking for, if that's what they're looking for. Your employer, after reviewing your medical leave request, might have additional questions about your request. Maybe they need additional information or additional documents from you or from your doctor. Many employees refuse to provide additional information for no good reason, on principle. They say to their employer, I gave you everything you need. I think you have enough. In my opinion, you have enough information in order to grant me my leave request, and I'm not going back to my doctor. Usually it's a mistake. It creates completely unnecessary frictions and disputes with management, and it even may lead to termination. And then making a case, making a disability or family leave discrimination case, is going to be quite difficult because your employer will be able to argue, hey, we didn't terminate this person because of disability. We terminated him or her because of his non-compliance with our policies. We asked for something simple and he didn't provide it to us. So you're much better off going back to your doctor and getting whatever information your employer needs in addition to whatever you already provided and getting that leave. Help your employer help you. Give them what they need in order to get that medical leave that you're asking for. This is a much better way to go in most cases. One significant exception, of course, is when whatever the employer is asking for is a very sensitive and very confidential information that has nothing to do with determining your medical leave request. Other than that, you should not be fighting your employer over providing additional information. Give it to them. A much easier and a much more simple solution to this problem, and an easy way to avoid completely unnecessary problems and conflicts at work. Mistake number two. This mistake I see over and over, and this is not only the mistake that employees make, but also their doctors. You cannot rely on your doctor to know all the intricacies of medical leave laws. They're charged with treating you, with providing you with healthcare, not with making sure that your workplace rights are protected. So it's very important that your medical leave or disability leave note has a date of return, has a date when you're supposed to go back to work with or without restrictions. It doesn't matter that you're not 100% sure that you will be able to go back to work on that day. At least have an anticipated date of return in your medical leave paperwork. Now, why is this important? The reason that this is important is because under the law, your employer is allowed to lawfully terminate you if, based on your medical leave paperwork, it appears that you might never come back to work or you will never come back to work. So if it seems like your leave will be indefinite, it's not clear whether you'll ever be able to work, your employer can separate you and say, hey, we didn't violate the law. If you plan to go back to work, make sure that your medical leave request and your paperwork that you submit to your employer has the following type of language. Mr. Such and such is expected to return to work or will return to work on such and such date with or without limitations, with or without restrictions. Then when that date comes and you feel that you're still unable to return to work because of your health condition or because of your injury, you can ask for extension. You can ask for a few more days, a few more weeks, or even a few more months if necessary. You can worry about it then, but make sure that every medical note that you provide has an expiration date. And this way, you will make sure that you do everything in your power to comply with disability laws and you're not making that type of common mistake that can lead to termination for no good reason. Thank you.